It's hard to believe 10 years have passed since Solaire Resort Entertainment City was launched. Indeed, except for how I look in these old videos, it doesn't seem that long ago that I was enjoying the views in their presidential suite, sipping a 20-year single malt at their whiskey lounge, or firing off at their indoor shooting range. Although those experiences are exclusive to VVIPs and members only, I'm pretty sure anyone who's had a chance to visit the integrated resort along Manila Bay will have fond memories of seeing an international performance at their state-of-the-art theater, or checking out the luxury fashion labels and timepieces at their elegant shopping arcade. Or indeed, memories of a fantastic meal at any one of their world-class restaurants. Solaire is known for having some of the finest restaurants in the city. And for their 10th year anniversary, they've managed to even top that feat with a gastronomic indulgence like no other. Welcome to Gastronomic Indulgence, a four-day culinary marathon held last March and spread out across Solaire's food and beverage outlets. To celebrate 10 years of setting gastronomic standards in the Philippines, Solaire invited internationally renowned chefs, sommeliers, and mixologists to share their creations with guests. Select media, executive class included, were first to experience a days-long celebration of fine food and fine spirits at a kickoff event held at the Italian restaurant Finestra, a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to enjoy a 10-course degustation prepared by five of the world's most talented chefs, 10 hands in all, with a combined 10 Michelin stars to their name. That's like one star for every year of Solaire.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone. I'm very honored to welcome you to our culinary experience. I'm very proud to be able to show you five of our master chefs who have come from all over the world to make sure that they show you their distinct flavors and culinary excellencies. I'm again very thrilled and super honored that Enrico Bartolini, Alvin Leung, Toru Nakamura, René Frank, Rui Silvestre have made their way to Solaire to celebrate with us.
Yes, you heard it right. Five chefs, 10 hands, working together in the kitchen, along with the respective teams and assistants, serve a 10-course meal, beginning with a starter of soup by Italian chef Enrico Bartolini of the three Michelin-starred Ristorante Enrico Bartolini at the Museo delle Culture in Milan.
The first course will be ravioli filled with lemon and oil, octopus, and a special fish soup, traditional recipe from Tuscany. Enjoy and thank you.
Bartolini has, of last count, a total of 12 Michelin stars spread out across 8 of the restaurants he helms in northern Italy. That alone probably conditioned my mind to believe his seafood soup is exceptional. But even if I wasn't aware of him, I'd still think so anyway. That's the thing about talent. No hype required. For the second course, it was 2 Michelin star chef Toru Nakamura's turn to impress.
So what we're gonna have on the plate is like koshihikari, like Japanese rice breed or sort, cooked almost like a sushi rice. And together we have toro, like the fatty belly part of the tuna. So it's almost the same like my name, but a little bit different.
The influence of Nakamura's Japanese heritage is obvious. The rice, slightly burned deliberately, is cooked in a pot the traditional way and then deep fried after. A delicious, crispy counterpoint to the velvety texture of the tuna belly and enjoyed with koji, a delicate fermented sauce made from edible fungus.
We took the shio koji and we made a kind of blanc, so it's also a little bit French-based what we cook. And that's the dish, a little bit nori on top, and we hope you enjoy it. So yeah, have fun with our dish.
But paired with premium sake, the dish is more than just fun. It's seriously delicious. No wonder Toru's restaurant, Schreiberei in Munich, earned 2 stars, even if it only opened last year. For the third course, wait, an eggplant dessert with pecan nuts and ice cream? And by a pastry chef at that?
Yes, of course. We want to show that dessert can be much more than the final course of a menu. And of course, it's a little bit unconventional to serve the dessert as a third course. We just want to showcase with this that our menu is a whole dinner menu just with desserts, but we like to balance the sweetness in the dishes also with some umami and some with saltiness, some acidity.
2022 World Pastry Chef awardee René Franck's 2 Michelin star Koda in Berlin is famous for reinventing desserts that can also be enjoyed as a main dish. He achieves this by blending unusual flavors, textures, and aromas, so the sweetness never overpowers the experience, but enhances it.
And the most important thing what we serve with the dessert is our pairing drink. So we have a pairing drink, which is 20 milliliters. It's a sherry, Oloroso, with oolong tea inside.
The fourth course is where the Portuguese chef Rui Silvestre comes in with a dish from his Michelin-starred restaurant Vistas in the southern province of Algarve.
Today I will be cooking a carabineiro dish. Carabineiro is a giant red prawn that we have a lot in Portugal and Spain. And I will combine with a curry and a lemon achar. So it's a combination between a luxury product and a family recipe. Thank you. A recipe from my grandmother. She's born in India, so it's a tribute to her. I hope you enjoy. Thank you.
I just love how a chef's ethnicity finds itself on the plate. The prawn curry dish is definitely an homage to his coastal hometown, Portugal. The spiced tapioca and curry, his Indian heritage. Did I say his was my favorite dish so far? In charge of the halfway point at dish number 5 is Hong Kongese Canadian chef Alvin Leung, better known among foodies as the Demon Chef for his irreverent approach to cuisine, not to mention his devilish sense of humor.
So the dish I'm presenting, the siobao, actually brought over by the Hakins, the Chinese, and actually it's the first time they brought wheat to the Philippines. So prior to that, everybody was eating rice. So we actually claim we brought wheat to the Philippines. So the dish I'm doing, the second dish, it's another inspired by another favorite dish of mine. Favorite snack in the Philippines, okay, arroz caldo.
Alvin Leung's reputation for extreme Chinese cuisine is not always as dramatic as it sounds. As his take on our very own rice porridge proves, the emphasis is clearly on the rich and complex flavors, and not just showmanship, even if he clearly loves an audience.
Now inside, we have a very, very rich chicken stock, all right? So rich, it's even richer than some of those Chinese up there in the back rack table. And then we have rice, we have morel mushrooms, and then you have that nice piece of calamansi right next to it, because I know here in the Philippines you love fresh and sour. Don't say anything else. I'm just getting too excited. I have to leave the room, drink cold waters, cold shower for me. All right, anyway, please enjoy. Thank you.
Behind the chef's rock and roll image is a serious self-taught chef with a background in molecular engineering. There's eccentricity in his choices for sure, real science as well, and 2 Michelin stars for it. Past the halfway point, each chef gets to offer a final dish. For Chef Nakamura, it's Wagyu beef tartare with caviar and chawanmushi. Now, that's rich.
So what we do is taking Kagoshima sirloin and we cure it overnight in like a little bit of sugar and salt and black pepper. And then we grill it just from the outside. Okay. And then we cut it into tartare cubes and mix it together with some oxtail consomme, some chive and some shallots. So this is on top of it. Then to make it a little bit more luxurious, there is sitting on some caviar, of course.
For Rui Silvestre, dish number 7 expresses his Indian heritage once again and his Portuguese love for seafood.
So it's a masala sauce with a poached rock lobster with a puree of celery root and black garlic. Enjoy.
For the 8th dish, Chef Enrico Bartolini returns with turbot with chicory and chicken liver sauce. The leaves of chicory served on top of caviar for a touch of luxury. If you think we'd all be stuffed by now, not at all. That's why these chefs are on top of their game. They know how to give you just enough to feel satisfied, yet still wanting more. which is dish number 9. Have Chef Alvin Leung once again.
So we have a nice, beautiful beef from Australia's Wagyu beef, and then we have some abalone, a little bit of Chinese inspiration. This is all comfort food, and I think what I find in the Philippines is here they love food,
yes.
And they love to be comfortable, and this is really comfortable. So I'm giving you some really luxurious comfort food, so I hope everybody enjoys it.
And before the last dish, I must mention the wines that these dishes have been paired with. All excellent choices made by top sommeliers from around the world who were also invited to the anniversary event. And now, finally, dessert. A surprising combination which only a genius like the world's top pastry chef could ever imagine.
So we made something refreshing and interesting. So we combined a grapefruit with a cabbage from Germany. Germany is known for cabbages. And we have a caramelized Savoy cabbage, which we incorporated in dessert, just to give it a bit of savoriness, a little bit umami in the dessert. And we combine it with a pairing drink.
Unconventional and unexpected, and each and every dish worth the Michelin stars that came with it. It may have taken me 10 years to experience the work of some of the most skilled, talented 10 hands in the world of gastronomy. And I wouldn't mind waiting another decade for an opportunity as amazing as this.